we're not mucking around anymore. We are serious about what we are doing.
What you're watching here is a community desperately fighting to hold on to 800 years of their culture and history.
We don't want to get violent.
These people are all that stands between sacred trees and bulldozers.
We're not going to consent to the machinery being placed on our...
Hours of a tense standoff finally come to an end as the police retreat. But this isn't the end of the story.
The landscape itself is very, very sacred. And what gives it its unique sacredness is that there's a birthing place, a birthing ground.
12 months ago, Zelenak Jabmara was working 9 to 5 in his own national business when he got the call that his ancestor's country was under threat.
I spoke to senior elder mum Sandra Onus, and she pretty much put it on me that I was the one. I had to stand up. I took off and left, and I haven't looked back since.
Zelenak now spends day and night here, watching over the trees in a makeshift embassy.
We can go anywhere in the world. There's an Australian embassy, there's an English embassy, there's an Italian embassy. So we figured that we may as well have a Djab Wurrung embassy that protects and preserves our birthright.
I've been here 4 months, and yeah, I'll stay right to the end.
I guess I've seen this a lot around in the news. I was interested to come down, have a chat, support, solidarity, I guess, yeah.
Elders say One Tree has seen 50 generations of Aboriginal women giving birth inside its hollow.
These are all spirit trees. These are trees that were planted with placenta and a seed from the bush tucker. And placenta come from spirit, come from life, come from human, you know, come from our ancestry. They're ours, they're our birthright. They belong to us. We belong to them.
So DT, what's the fate of this directions tree?
She's one of the ones that are marked for destruction. She's one of the ones that are marked to go. She's very, very, very magic and very majestic, very spiritually entwined and intact. I was just yarned to her before about, you know, bringing lots of the children back this way so she can pour some of that knowledge and wisdom into them children.
But a highway upgrade means that knowledge could be eliminated.
This stretch of highway that they're camped out on is one of the busiest in the state, connecting Melbourne all the way to Adelaide. Now, plans to upgrade it will involve about 12 kilometres of trees in that direction being demolished for a bypass.
The developer is Major Road Projects Victoria, and they say this stretch of highway is deadly. With more and more trucks and cars on the road, more lanes are needed. The fight has divided the nearby town of Ararat into two camps, those for the road and those for the trees.
Yeah, I think it's a good idea. Yeah, there's definitely a lot more traffic coming up here these days, so it's nice to get people here more safely.
It's taken too long.
Why is it taking too long?
Well, the Aboriginals have decided that they need all this stuff, and they decide to make a claim when things are starting to happen. It's going to happen regardless, so they need to just sort of let it happen so that it makes it easier for everybody.
They were here before we were. The trees were here before we were. And I think cars should be second or third, not first.
I just wish they had stopped all the nonsense and had it finished by now.
What is the nonsense that's going on?
Well, with all the disruptions, they're no further advanced. They're going to save the trees they wanted to save. And I've seen several very serious accidents because it's not finished, and I can't wait for it to be finished.
We've never been opposed to a highway as such. We're just opposing that particular 12.5 kilometre stretch because it is very, very significant and culturally significant to our dreaming, and it belongs to the dreaming and the story here.
It's this connection which Zelenak says the state is trying to cut. Last month, he was arrested and held in a cell for 26 days for failing to appear in court after driving with an expired licence. Supporters say he was taken away from the embassy so that it would fail.
Well, about the time that he was arrested, Vic Roads was due to move in and start their roadworks and destroying the land, basically. That just seems to be a bit odd that they've taken, you know, my son off country.
This is standard practice for the white man to take us people off country for very minor offences. When's it gonna stop?
I'm feeling very, very strong. I'm feeling very emotional. I'm just glad to be home with my family and friends.
Even the judge said 26 days in jail was too harsh a penalty for a minor offence. So, Zelenak, how does it feel to be home?
Oh, it feels absolutely amazing to be home. Just to be able to sit and see what's been happening, and just to sit and have some laughs, but also just to be able to sit on country and just to, you know, feel it, and yeah, it's just enlightened my spirit. But I'd just, you know, continue work as usual for me.
One Aboriginal organisation has worked with major road projects to protect what they call 15 of the most culturally significant trees.
There was a deep community consultation process, and recent meetings at Eastern Mar feel like the cultural threshold has been reached and the cultural heritage is going to be protected. They're just all in between there, yeah. They're kind of all scattered around. And we fought really hard to do that, and through our processes we've actually identified more culturally significant trees, and we've actually managed to save them as well.
But Zelenak says 15 trees is not good enough. He wants the land returned to the Djab Wurrung people.
It's not just trees that we're talking about here. It's a whole land, it's a whole landscape. The land, Mother Earth, is the roots of my existence and where I come from are as deep as the roots that are entwined in the land.
While Zelenak and his community use their bodies to block bulldozers, their lawyers are taking the fight to the courts.
I think there's an issue of institutional control and institutional denial. And if the government would open up and accept that they've made a mistake, everyone will win.
It turns out the highway might not have to go through these trees at all.
So what we've got here, this is...
That's the Western Highway.
That's the Western Highway.
And this is the proposed option one, which will go through the farmland community, through the Djab Wurrung area.
Yep.
The embassy and their lawyer say an alternative northern route could be the solution.
The northern option basically hugs this highway, uses an easement along here, a treeless easement, a power line easement. So that's why it has far less impact. There's no impact on cultural heritage. So the cultural significance, if the northern option is built, is minimal.
But Major Road Projects has dismissed this option, saying this route would be less safe, have inferior access for the local community, poorer environmental outcomes, would cost more, and would be very unlikely to meet planning and environmental requirements. The fate of this land now rests in the hands of the new Federal Environment Minister, Susan Lee, who has the power to go above the state and protect the entire landscape.
I just hope Minister Lee will come to what I think is a reasonable conclusion.
So how optimistic are you that this application will be successful?
I'm quite optimistic. I'm more than 50% optimistic. I can't think of any reason to not grant protection.
The Feed asked Minister Lee for an interview. Instead, her office told us the minister needs to be briefed on the issue before she makes a decision. But either way, Zelenak says he's not moving.
I'm prepared to die for my country, as my old people have done before me. I'm prepared to die for my country, to give a place to our women and children, which is what is our cultural inheritance anyways.
That's how much it means to you.
Yeah. I've written out my will. My kids know what's happening.
Hey there, my name is Mark Fennell, and if you enjoyed that, and I'm hoping that you did, then make sure you like and subscribe to the Feed's YouTube channel, and definitely watch that thing that I have absolutely seen before. It's really good.